Everyone, greetings from the Health and Beyond group. Today we have amongst us Dr. Sharda Jain, a leading obstetrician and gynecologist, who will be discussing about polycystic ovarian syndrome or PCOS. Dr. Sharda Jain is fondly known as Teacher of Teachers. She is the Director of Life Care Center and Life Care IVF. She is also the Founder and Secretary General of Delhi Gynecologist Forum and also the Founder and Chairperson of the North India Gynecologist Forum. So welcome, Dr. Sharda Jain. We will now go live on some of the issues around PCOS. So first of all, our viewers would like to know, what is PCOD and how is it different from PCOS?
Very rightly you've asked this particular question because it confuses many of the people. What is PCOS and what is PCOD? One thing I just wish to tell you that as far as this PCOS or PCOD is concerned, it is a very perplexing problem. It affects a woman or an adolescent girl both metabolically, reproductively. It affects the cardiovascular system as well as psychological health of hers. So as far as these two terms are concerned, PCOS means that this particular patient has got not only endocrine problems, she has got metabolic problem as well, which has got long association with cardiovascular health. She can have, you know, increased, you know, predilection is there for endometrial cancer because of endometrial hyperplasia in such cases. While in PCOD, it is mainly endocrine problems. She has got overweight or obesities, and there is oligoanovulation or anovulation, and on an ultrasound, it shows a polycystic ovarian disease. Any of the two features are there, we say that patient had got PCOS. So these are the two terms, PCOS and PCOD. Is in PCOD, there are common certain things, but in polycystic ovarian syndrome, there's an additional metabolic effects are seen, and then we call it as a polycystic ovarian disease. But even with the doctor community, gynecologist community, they just use it, you know, without thinking about much about it.
Interchangeably, it's not an interchangeable term. These are different terms.
If I told you that PCOS means that you have got a metabolic syndrome as well. While people are using left and right, both the same things, you know, they think they is the same.
Okay, thank you, Dr. So we have reports now of increasing cases of PCOS in the recent years. So is it due to better reporting or better detection as compared to earlier times, or are we actually having an actual increase? Because we do hear of this, you know, it's quite common these days to hear of this problem among young adolescent girls, especially. So
I wish to tell my viewers is that, you know, that this particular problem existed in ancient times. Even Hippocrates, who said to be father of the medicine, he mentioned about it, that here there are many women who are masculine, have features, they have a robust body, they menstruate irregularly, and they can't become pregnant. So, but what I found is, when I was a student, from that particular time and now, PCOS has just suddenly proliferated, which has come in the last 15, 20 years. We find that it is more seen in the metros, where it is not seen, it is not a problem of a rural India. It boils down to everything is lifestyle. Ladkiyon ko padhne ke liye jaldi diya ja raha hai. The mother and the families are very liberal about them. Bhai, tu padh le, kuch mat karo. So the result is that lifestyle has changed completely, lack of exercise, and this junk food and things like that have aggravated their problems. So first thing, they become overweight or obese, and then repercussions of endocrine problems follows after. So anytime she normalizes her weight, things revert back to normal. So polycystic ovarian disease, just like a diabetes, one can say you can control it, you can revert back to it.
So Dr. Jain, if we understand correctly, you say this is a modern lifestyle. It's a lifestyle disease. It's not something genetic or not caused by any other.
I will not say that it is not genetic. Let me be very frank with you. There is something like genetics and epigenetics. Now, whenever the environment is created, then only the disease is going to manifest.
Okay.
It is like this. I may be having genes, but if I all my work as the Westerner, though, in Western world, you don't find that kind of an incident. It is only seen in Asian people much, much more than the Western people. It is also not seen in the rural India.
Dr. Jain, so as a practicing gynecologist, what has your experience been in such cases? Like, you are a clinical practicing doctor. So what do you say? How many percentage of your cases actually have this among young adolescent girls?
See, as far as Indian figures are concerned, they vary something like between 5 to 25%. Roughly, we see around 10%. But if we take concentrate on adolescent girls, then I think the number is something like 25%. So it all depends, you know, what kind of clientele you have to say that. But roughly, you can say it is 10%. But say, if you take all patients with hirsute and acne, you'll find polycystic ovarian disease is the underlying feature in a good 75% of patients. So one thing is clear that, you know, this particular problem in adolescent girls is pretty common in our country, pretty common. It's about 20 to 30% of the adolescent girls which come to us, we find that they are having polycystic ovarian disease. They are overweight, they are obese, they have menstrual problem. They have, you know, menstrual history is they have majority of the time that they have a delayed periods. But sometimes they can have, you know, prolonged periods, which is going on for months together. That is the kind of things are there. And they find that, you know, there's a difficulty in conceiving the cases. And I find good, you know, about 9, 10% of patients do have abnormal glucose tolerance. And we find even mild hypertension is seen in some patients, especially if the parents are also hypertensive and obese. So I think, you know, for adolescent, it is becoming a big problem. And the ones which are to be seen and watched are the ones who are overweight and obese.
So what can be done? How can we manage PCOS? Like, what would you suggest? Like, is it as you said, exercise is less, they have a sedentary lifestyle. Also food, you're saying that junk food is one of the culprits. So what should they do if one has PCOS? How does that person manage this disease?
See, I am is very
education,
clear.
Early detection.
Yes. I'm very clear. They require a couple of sitting with parents that you got to normalize your weight. Whether you like it or you do not like it, they have to normalize their weight. Unless they normalize their weight by, you know, great check on your sleeping pattern, their exercise and their diet, I think, you know, they cannot come back to normal. So they have to decide themselves whether they want to be on the pills and pills and pills. Pills have to be taken. But normalization of weight means 50% job is done.
Okay, that's encouraging to know.
50% job is done. And secondly, mind you, 500 cut in calories will decrease their weight in 6 months' time. Only 500, which is not much.
No, it's not much.
If you aim, see, हम लोग जब अपने बातों की जगलरी में लगाते हैं तो घबरा जाते हैं वो लोग। भाई तुमको 500 कैलोरीज कम करनी है, 6 महीने में बेटा तेरा 10 किलो वजन कम हो जाए। So once the parents are clean, she's also very clear. कम नमक खाना है, शुगर कम खानी है, फैट कम खाना है, और ये ट्रांसफैट वाली चीजें वो सब बिल्कुल बंद करना। इसका मतलब है बाहर का खाना और बाहर का खाना बंगा के खाना दोनों चीजें आपके लिए गड़बड़ है ट्रांस फैट इज गोइंग टू नॉक योर ओवरीज दे गोइंग टू नॉक योर थायराइड्स यू विल हैव एडिशनल प्रॉब्लम्स सो यू हैव टू डिसाइड अबाउट योरसेल्फ व्हेदर यू वांट टू बी हेल्दी और व्हेदर यू डोंट वांट टू बी हेल्दी एज वी हैव जस्ट नाउ सेड इफ शी हैज अ पीसीओ पॉलीसिस्टिक ओवेरियन सिंड्रोम इट मींस ऑलरेडी हार्ट इज गेटिंग इफेक्टेड ऑन दैट पर्टिकुलर साइड देन शी हैज टू गेट बॉदर्ड अबाउट इट एट दैट टाइम यू से उनका बीपी 130/85 से ज्यादा होगी उनकी कमर 80 से ज्यादा 80 सेंटीमीटर से ज्यादा होगी उनके ट्राइग्लिसराइड 150 से ज्यादा होंगे उनका गुड कोलेस्ट्रॉल एचडीएल है वो 50 से कम होगा So all that, and the blood sugar will be more than 110 fasting. So what I'm trying to say, once they know that these are five features, usme teen features honge, to iska matlab metabolic syndrome ho gaya. They have no other choice but to get on to work and very heavily on their lifestyle, and then only they can think about curing. We give initially, oral contraceptive pills, which are a little special. They normalize their high androgen level. But the parents as well as the girl should definitely know, jis ladki ne seekh liya hai, uske liye sab, she can easily overcome it. And the people have not been able to learn it, they have difficult time. Mind you, not only they have difficult time, in adolescent, what is bothering her? What is bothering her is acne and the hair. Her delayed periods are not bothering her so much.
Okay.
But her face is bothering her.
Okay.
Then her mother is bothered about the menstrual period. Madam, 2 months period, nahi aaya, 1.5 months period, nahi aaya, 3 months period. Mother is more bothered about the period, but she is not bothered. Mm-hmm. She's bothered about her looks.
Is it possible for a person to be thin and also have this?
Yes.
It is.
Yes, but it is like this. 10-15% are thin PCOS, while majority of them are obese PCOS.
Mm-hmm.
And secondly is that, once they become married, then mm-hmm. conception is also a big problem. You find that in good 60-65% patients, infertility is bothering them. And again, what I've seen, they have to go to the gynecologist. 25-30% are easy ones. You get them investigated, basic investigation, you give them medicine, they become pregnant. The people who don't become pregnant within 2 years of their treatment, they will require IVF.
Okay, thank you, Dr. Jain. This was so, informative for everybody. And I'm sure a lot of people will get, enlightened on this topic. And because a lot of people actually want a doctor to speak about this rather than, just general information that we find on the net. So thank you so much. And looking forward to seeing you again and talking to you. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Thank you.